woman standing on the show rock star in excess. We all remember Toronto native Suzie McNeil rocking out there. And she's back with a new album dropping November 4th, and she joins us in our BT studios. Welcome, Suzie.
Hello. How are you? Good. I was very nervous there.
Well, let's talk about Rockstar in Excess. Now, there has got to be a challenge for artists when they go on that show to be actually taken credibly and to remain legitimate. What kind of struggles have you had from being a reality star to actually a serious recording artist?
I haven't actually really sort of come up across any problems with that. I think that we've come a long way since like the first American Idol, as far as the acceptance factor goes for those kinds of shows. Like now you turn on the radio and how many of the hits are people that have come from one of those reality shows? It had a certain quality that Mark Burnett and all the producers wanted to establish in the show. It wasn't like we were on The Surreal Life. Mm-hmm. Though I wouldn't rule that show out if they asked. No.
The first single off the new album is called Rock and Roller.
Yeah.
And the first single is called Let's Go.
Yeah.
And that was actually the theme song to the YTV show, The Next Star. Mm-hmm. And you were a celebrity judge on that show. What was it like to be on that show and have the tables turned on you?
It was really cool, actually. I wasn't sure. I was worried I would feel old.
Mm-hmm. I think we have some footage of that video, too.
You do. Yeah. But I didn't. It was a great experience, actually. Yeah. The thing that I learned the most from that show, actually, which sort of resonated with me, was what the it factor is. Because we see so many kids coming in one after another and having to sort of, very tired, we went across Canada, filter through these kids and figure out, like, who could actually be a star. And it wasn't very difficult. Because I got to tell you, the it factor now, I sort of know what it means. It's someone who walks into a room and there's just that special something about them.
Yeah, that quality.
Yeah, they own the room.
And it's like, you can't even define it sometimes. It's just this aura you almost pick up.
No, and there was a big difference between the kids who had that and who didn't. So,
interesting.
Yeah, it was a fun show.
Now, everyone knows you're not up there singing Celine Dion. You've got this total rock image, rock sound. When I think of, you know, heroines of rock music, I think of Heart, Stevie Nicks, Janis Joplin, Blondie. Of course, you were doing Blondie on that show. And I love your look, too. So who are your influences in terms of image and sound?
Well, I got to say that right now, in the sort of music climate, there isn't much rock, women singing rock. And it's never been easy. You know, the Lilith Fairs and the Sheryl Crows and the people who've sort of kept it alive. Now, if you listen to the radio, it's kind of like, really just Pink is sort of holding the torch there. And she's doing really well, so I'm really happy about that. But, you know, I think any strong kind of woman that in the past, the ones who aren't with us anymore, the Janis Joplins, to the Heart, to all of them, inspire me, because rock to me, and I'm not sure why I should think about it, is a strong style of music, and a woman singing it is usually going to be a really strong woman, and she knows what she wants, and you know, men can't mess with us. No, I'm not a man hater. I love men.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I'm proud to be holding that torch. It's who I am. I am a strong person. So, I want to keep rock alive, and I want to be there for anyone else who wants it.
Well, we have a picture of the album cover for Rock and Roller. It comes out November 4th. And what can we expect from this album?
Well, we like to call that picture specifically Legs.
Yes.
That one is entitled Legs. This record is different from my first one. Same producer, which keeps, you know, for the fans who like the first one, but it's a lot more up-tempo. Mm-hmm. You know, whenever I hear albums, I like them to have sort of a theme of, you know, do you put it on when you're sitting by the fire having a glass of wine, or do you put it on when you're working out? This one's a pretty high-energy record. I wrote almost all the songs, like all but one I co-wrote, so that's different for me as well.
Right.
It's a lot more of who I am, and it's like kind of quirky pop rock, so I like it.
Very cool. Well, we have to leave it there for time, but thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
All right, new album again, November 4th, is called Rock and Roller. It's the sophomore album from Suzie McNeil. Check it out.